Riley, this week we are joined by a very special guest.
Oh, is that accurate? Very what? Special?
Also, doubly, triply special. We're all in the same physical space.
Yes, that is. That's the special part. So we're joined by a guest, Vince, better known as Pleasant Kenobi.
Yeah. Yeah, hi guys.
And we're watching Caleb Durward break MTG Arena, Dennis.
There is a hidden third option. You don't always have to win or lose a game of Magic. Yeah. Well, most games go that way.
That is true.
But there is a third option, which is just to just shatter the very fabric of the game.
I guess at least it doesn't crash like some other unnamed Magic programs might do.
Well, the thing is, I think that is actually quite a large mercy here, because right now, I mean, I hope that Caleb has a very empty schedule for the rest of the week.
Right.
Because he's going to be, there's no chess clock. There's no timing out. He's going to be here a very, very long time.
Someone can call Wizards though, and then maybe one of them will get banned.
I guess that's his out.
That's his out.
That's his out. Chris Clay, there has to be some divine intervention here.
How do you guys feel about ooze noises, just in your general day-to-day life?
Personally, I'm quite into them. I own a lot of pots of ooze at home. I squelch them regularly. It's a relaxing thing.
Boy, oh boy, do we have the clip for you then, Vince. So what's going on here is the opponent has adapted a Terramander, and then the Niv-Mizzet's going to ping it, and then they're like, well, whatever, I'll just adapt it again, again and again and again, and every time Arena slams in that little squelchy animation, layers the audio over and over and over again until we are just knee-deep in ooze.
We are so deep into the ooze here. We're so deep into the ooze that our hero is absorbing their own opt, Dennis, just to keep the pings coming, just so we can enjoy some of that top shelf audio.
I mean, some people might think this is a bug, but personally, I think this is definitely a feature.
Oh, as Chris Clay intended, this is firing on all cylinders, and this really is what the next generation of Magic as a Digital Expression is all about.
Guys, Super Mad Lad here is about to draw, conservatively, a million cards.
That's a conservative estimate here. Mastermind's Acquisition goes and gets Axis of Mortality. We've got all sorts of jank on the screen here, Vince, and things about to get pretty buck wild.
I mean, draw a card is the best three words in Magic, but I mean, draw a million cards, or as close to, is probably some of the strongest words in Magic.
Yeah, this is limit approaching a million. So they swap life totals with the Axis of Mortality, which, as far as Lich's Mastery is concerned, is just gaining a butt ton of life.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And you get to pick up your deck and put that whole thing in your hand. But that's not all.
Look at this. Look at that.
41 cards drawn.
Look at that solitaire win game animation there. But where is it? Where's the special piece of Magic?
Special piece. Awaken the erstwhile. Ditch all those back away and put a whopping 36 4/4s into play.
We are not afraid to settle the record here, boys.
No. Oh, no. We're getting in there. And I love that was a real whirlwind tour for the cards that were drawn. They come there, little special guest appearance, and then straight to the bin.
Yeah. Amazonian here giving Frank Carson a run for his money. So there is a rich tapestry of blockers on screen here, and I personally can't begin to parse this for even a second.
Oh, no. This is one of those situations where I think you just start throwing your cardboard at their cardboard and hoping that some of it sticks. This is a professional basket weaving course. Look at this.
It's a cartoon operator's board with the cables. They're just like plugging them in.
Connecting phone lines.
Phone calls to connect.
So Amazonian, though, has very much seen the code.
She's on another level.
Looking through the curtain of the Matrix.
This is a Neo level.
She's decided on the blocks, and lo and behold, Danny Trejo goes to a very comfortable one life when all is said and done.
Just as she drew it up.
What the hell is the damage total?
Oh my god! I'm a big fan of coin flips. And Vince, I know you're a big fan of currency-based media.
Currency jokes are my favorite, absolute favorite.
But we've had a lot of coin flip wins on top five.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we are firm subscribers to the belief that it's better to be lucky than good, Dennis.
And Knox is going to show us right here the best set of these I've ever seen. He wins 11 coin flips in a row.
11 coin flips of this mirror match. He puts half a squillion billion power into play because they're all lords as well. What are the odds of this happening?
I haven't run the numbers, but it's roughly somewhere around 0.00048828125.
And look at his little face. He goes from childlike joy to this evil sort of grin. And oh, mate, I love this.
Thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen. If you have your own submissions to MTG Top 5, either tweet them at us with hashtag MTG Top 5 or email them in to submissions@channelfireball.com.